We as Baldwinians are fortunate indeed to be a part of the quasicentennial celebrations this year of the Baldwin Institutions. About 125 years ago, through the generous donations of one Mr. John Baldwin, the Baldwin Schools began. And today we have about a dozen Baldwin institutions which are diversified in many an aspect of education in the city of Bangalore. And we wish that this institution, which has high levels of integrity and high levels of academic perfection, will go on to cater to the needs of the children who come to the portals of Baldwin Institutions.
Don't see anyone coming to the field today. Why? Where have all these fools gone?
Yes, sir. This is the first time they are absent on the field.
Sir!
Sir, I know what has taken place. One foreign lady is going around house to house asking and requesting the parents to encourage the children to go to school. And she has already succeeded in getting a very good response. Sir, many children are planning to go to school.
There are few schools already. What's new about it?
Her main focus is on the education of girls. That makes the difference.
Come on, I know what to do next.
ಭವಿಷ್ಯವೊಂದೇ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಬರುವಾಗ ಪಡೆಯುತ್ತೇವೆ ಜೀವನ ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷ. ಆ ದಿನ ಬರುವಾಗ ಪಡೆಯುತ್ತೇವೆ ಜೀವನ ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷ. ಹೋಯ್ ಆಕಾಶ ನೀನು ಹಾಡು ಹಾಡುತ್ತೀಯ, ದೇವರು ನಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವರು.
ನೋಡು ನೋಡು ಎಂತಹ ಮಹಾನ ದೇವರು ನಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವರು. ಓ ಆಕಾಶ ನೀನು ಹಾಡು ಹಾಡುತ್ತೀಯ, ಓ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೀಯ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗ್ಲಾಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ಡ್ ಮೀ. Awake, my dear people. It is time to look at the light of wisdom. Walking in the light, one will never fall. I am Mrs. Mary A. Oldham, wife of Bishop William F. Oldham, the pastor of the Methodist Church. Our mission is that of Jesus' mission. To spread the good news and to lead people to a harmonious life. Let the children of this area learn good and do good. Look, I am planning to open a small school at my house in number 2 Alexandra Street, Bangalore. So my humble request for all of you is to encourage your children, especially girls, to get educated.
For the boys, it's okay. Why do you need the girls?
Correct. What are we going to get by educating girls?
Every child is precious. Every child is unique. Let our daughters become the polished corners of a temple. It is our responsibility to build a better future for all children.
My child, you are so lucky. She will teach you lessons.
Yes, mommy. But you too should learn.
Oh my god! What to do now? Look, he's coming!
Who?
The landlord!
Run, run!
Don't run, children. Don't be afraid of me anymore. I heard all your conversation. Yes, I too will join in this mission of literacy.
Sir, then who will work in these fields?
No more child labor. Let all the children attend the school.
I am Brigadier Malcolm. We, the entire military unit, are happy to have you in our midst. Please let us know when and how you need our service.
From tomorrow, we will see a new beginning, a new dawn, bringing joy to all.
I am your beloved Baldwin Academy. With your blessings, love and care, I was born in 1879. In and through the efficient hands of Mrs. Mary A. Oldham in number 2 Alexandra Street, Bangalore. First, I was named the Methodist Episcopal School. Oh, what a wonderful day it was to see little ones coming to me to learn. Just 4 students and 1 teacher. A real family atmosphere. Everyone made me feel proud as they grew up day by day in wisdom and knowledge. Days passed. Then a year later, When the Oldhams left India for theological studies, they handed me to the worthy hands of Bishop John Edward Robinson. He was, in fact, taking up a great challenge. How could he raise the number of students and get more teaching staff? Where and how could they have a spacious building and a large ground? How could he get funds to realize these dreams? Good morning, Reverend Robinson.
Good morning.
I am Miss Hill, living in Nilgiris. By the way, I read your newsletter. I do really appreciate your dedication and spirit to empower and educate all sections of children. I was really sad to know about the shortage of funds and the lack of teachers.
We hope to get some helping hand, which will help the school come up.
Sure. Here I am to offer my services as a teacher.
Wonderful. May God bless you. You are most welcome.
Good morning, friends. I am Reverend Marion Kirk from America.
Welcome to Bangalore. I am Reverend Robinson. What can I do for you?
Oh, you're Reverend Robinson. Glad to meet you. What a joy it was to read about you and about your school. Forget about the initial struggles. These little worries are nothing compared to the challenges you people have undertaken. What you're doing is nothing but the proclamation of God's word, believe it or not. I have left my home and my country only to take part in the mission that you are doing. Yes, I am at your disposal. Make use of my services as you wish.
This is incredible. God, how can I render thanks to thee? Marvelous are your ways. Welcome, Reverend Marion.
On February 1880, I began to function on rented land along Hosur Road. Reverend Kirk as the first principal and Miss Hill as the first teacher led me on a victorious journey. They really proved themselves as good and excellent guides to the children. Reverend Kirk was a man of many talents. Besides being an administrator, he was also a cook, barber, teacher, musician, and a good sportsman. Yes, he had a fine way of encouraging boys in sports. ...1882 was a jackpot year in my life, at the time of Reverend Ira A. Richards.
Often I think what an enormous task it is to run a Christian mission school which takes care of the holistic needs of the children. The Methodist school in Bangalore is one of that kind. But they are in a big crisis due to lack of funds. Yes, I am willing to donate a sufficient grant to them for the development of the school.
My dear students, I have some great and good news for you. The long-awaited dreams of our former principals are coming true. A man of God, a warm-hearted human, Mr. John Baldwin has donated $8,000 to acquire land and buildings for our school. I am indeed happy to welcome our benefactor, philanthropist, Mr. John Baldwin of USA.
Vandanam,
vandanam,
swagatam.
1883, I was renamed Baldwin High School. The name Baldwin descends from a royal lineage and is of German extraction, meaning bold winner. Yes, John Baldwin was a bold winner, and all Baldwinians are bold winners. In 1884, some new faces arrived. The kindergarten class was opened. Principals, Bishop William F. Oldham, Reverend J. E. Robinson, Reverend Ira A. Richards, Reverend B. T. Eddy, Reverend W. Bowser, Reverend Homer Stuntz, Reverend W. L. King, Reverend W. H. Hollister left no stone unturned to strengthen me in a holistic manner. My growth in this garden city was very dynamic. In my task of educating children, there were not only joyful days, also several obstacles. God's grace helped me to turn the stumbling blocks into stepping stones. In 1890, during the time of Reverend T.R. Toussaint,
Sir, the government has come to know that your school is doing well and you get sufficient support of finance. So we have decided to withdraw the grant in aid.
What are we going to do now? Without the grant in aid, how will we run the school? Many staff members have left the school and joined elsewhere, where they get more salary.
Come what may, no question of closing down the school. Where there is fire, I prefer to put it off rather than running away. Yes. I will operate it without grants of any kind.
But the strength was in his willpower that in his time itself, the government grant and aid was not only restored but also increased. 1902. One morning during the assembly.
Good morning, friends. Today's Bangalore Daily Post has a write-up. Bangalore has some flourishing scholastic institutions, among which Baldwin holds a very high place. In retrospect, over the past 6 years, it places Baldwin schools on a sound base, and now commands a wide patronage from Karachi in the west to Burma and Malaysia in the east.
Dear staff and students, today is a golden day for the Baldwin family. Our institution has grown into such perfection that we begin to go one step further in separating into the boys' and the girls' schools. The Baldwin Boys' School is placed under the Board of Foreign Missions, and the Baldwin Girls' School comes under the Women's Foreign Missionary Society. We are really proud and privileged to have Mr. P.V. Roberts as the new principal of the boys' section. He was a Baldwinian, a teacher in our school when he was just 17, and also a headmaster. And now God has chosen him to be your principal. And I do welcome Miss Montgomery as the first principal of Baldwin Girls High School.
Loyalty and service, righteousness and truth are my motto, and this is my internal strength. There was yet another tragic setback for me in 1927 during the time of Mr. C.N. Weston, the first Anglo-Indian principal.
Look, Mr. Weston, it is not a joke to run the school in this condition. We are in debt. Methodist Church is no more in a position to help it out. How are we going to pay the salaries? Remember, at present, there are 75 boys in the boarding. To see to their needs alone, for me, it looks so impossible. So, we have decided to close down the school.
Pastor, please have patience. When all the doors are shut, somewhere, at least a window will open. Give me one more year. God willing, we shall rescue the school from this crisis.
Tell me, have you got any concrete plans?
Yes, Pastor. No salary. Only readiness and willingness for the mission. Yes, this dedication will do wonders. I will be the first not to take any salary. This spirit I shall try to inculcate in the staff members. Moreover, to raise the funds, the Students' Association has decided to bring food from their homes and sell them in the school campus. This money will be used for the developmental works.
Yes, it was the never say no attitude of Mr. C.N. Weston that helped me to be what I am today. Miss Irene Wells, who was principal from March 1959 to 1960, gave to my children the student government known as the Baldwin Democratic Organization. The election of student leaders is done democratically, and the campus resounds with the tramp of determined feet marching, yelling for their favorite candidate, making their voices hoarse with rousing cheer. Miss Anne May Tillow found the Opportunity School. You know how thrilled I was at this new mission and venture, a pioneering institution in the field of special education in India for children with intellectual impairment. Today, the Opportunity School completes 42 years of its caring mission. Children share equal opportunities with their normal peers, all educational, extracurricular, and socially interactive activities in an inclusive environment, which is the benchmark of inclusive education. I had very painful incidents too in my life. In 1967, Dr. Hezekiel Pashad became my principal and served only just for 40 days. He was tragically taken from our midst when the school van in which he was traveling to Kolar skidded and overturned near Hoskote, killing him and injuring few of our beloved friends. Yes, the painful memory still lingers in my heart.
Dr. Pashad met with an accident.
Not only excelled in academics, but their talents shone at national and international levels. Right from the early 50s, my students excelled in the field of sports. In the year 1948, in World Olympics, my boys, Eric Prabhakar, participated in the 200 meters race, and Henry Rebello did wonders in the triple jump. In 1962, Sheila Paul emerged as the fastest Indian at the All India National Track and Field event. The swimming pool was inaugurated in 1976. And from then it has emerged as a nursery for national swimmers. My girls, Anisha Prasad, Shanaz Shakur and Punita Gupta represented India at the Asian Games.
Anisha, Anisha, Shanaz, Punita, Anisha, Shanaz, Punita.
In 1971, an orchestra was started. Many former students excelled in the field of music, like Mr. Sandeep Chautha, Bollywood music director. Drama.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I have come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them, but the good is oft interred with their bones. And let it be with Caesar.
In dance, my NCC brass band made me proud by participating in the Republic Day parade in Delhi. Soon, an all-girl band was established. the KPMG athletic meets, my students grabbed the overall championship trophy and retained it for the last 7 years continuously.
Yay, yay, Baldwin! KPMG once again! 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 Yay, yay, Baldwin!
My girls kept my name on top of the world. Audrey Mabin became the first lady pilot who flew from Bangalore to Nasik in a microlight aircraft all alone.
Fly high, Audrey Mabin! 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 Fly high, Audrey
Mabin! In 1965, Dr. Sarah L. Kashiram took over as the principal and was one of the most loved and admired principals. During her long tenure of 23 years, her hard work and perseverance placed Baldwin's on the map of the world. Yes, in all these trials and tribulations, it was the unconditional dedication and the give and take family spirit of Baldwinians that helped me to sail smoothly. The cardinal principle on which the Baldwin Academy was founded was service. When we put the love of Jesus into action, it becomes service to fellow human beings and loyalty to God. With God's grace, we have always remained true to our motto. Every child is precious. Every child is unique at Baldwin's, and I want to reach out to every child. Children are our heritage and hope for tomorrow. In 1993, one more new dimension was added to academics, a polytechnic diploma course in computer and commercial practice, both for boys and girls. Moreover, in 2004, another challenge I had to face was the education of the marginalized and catering to the needs of the adult illiterate women. Over the years, I have supported poor students, paying their fees, buying books and uniforms. The lonely and old people of the old age homes and homes of the destitute are my special concern. Today, I am 125 years old. Not really old, but 125 years young. Let me thank you all, my well-wishers, benefactors, parents, teachers, students and friends. From you, with you and for you, I was born. In all my joys and sorrows, your helping hand is seen and it will be remembered till the end of time. I do remember with gratitude all my principals who rendered selfless service to my children. Reverend M. B. Kirk, Reverend I. A. Richards, Reverend B. T. Eddy, Reverend W. Bowser, Reverend Homer Stuns, Reverend W. L. King, Reverend W. H. Hollister, Reverend T. R. Toussaint, Reverend C. W. Ross D'Souza, Reverend P. V. Roberts, Reverend J. B. Buttrick, Reverend A. B. Coates, Reverend J. W. Simmons, Reverend E. J. Guest, Reverend H. F. Hilmer, Reverend E. A. Scammons, Reverend A. F. Cook, Reverend Z. A. Olson, Mr. C. N. Weston, Mr. R. A. B. Anderson, Dr. E. B. Finch, Mr. B. S. Gershom, Reverend F. Kokavi, Dr. H. Prashad, Ms. C. Christadas, Reverend S. Kamalesan, Reverend S. Downs, Mr. Dattu Samuel, Mr. J. S. Williams, Mr. M. George, Mr. P. K. Das, Mr. Gilbert Samuel, Mr. G. Mohan Murthy, Dr. K. J. N. Karunakaran, Miss Erdell Montgomery, Miss A. J. Holland, Miss Elizabeth M. Benthine, Miss Fanny Fern Fisher, Miss Ida G. Ishan, Miss Margaret Ernsberger, Miss Muriel E. Robinson, Miss May Weston, Miss Edith Delima, Miss Ruth N. Daniels, Miss Irene Wells, Miss Frances Johnson, Dr. Sarah Kashiram, Miss Rose Vishwasam, Miss Santosha Peter, Mrs. Lila Thomas, Mrs. Grace Peter, Miss S. Karodi, Mrs. Joyce Davis, Dr. Vasanta Edward. Dear children, as you step into a brighter future, everyone gathered here would like to bless you, saying, March, Baldwin's march, and set Bangalore a-ringing. March, Baldwin's march, on to glory and the fame of history. March, on to greater heights of achievement.
Rise, little ones, Baldwin, yes. Rise, little ones, Baldwin, yes. Rise with all the highest mountains. Rise with all the highest mountains. To the endless boundaries of life. Rise and shine, rise and shine, rise and shine.
My dear staff and students, I know you are waiting to celebrate my birthday. I'm really glad to see you rejoicing on this day. My special thanks to you, my beloved Bishop, Right Reverend S.V. Sampath Kumar and Mrs. Dorothy Sampath Kumar for being my patrons and enabling me to impart wisdom and knowledge to thousands of children and more. I remain grateful to Dr. K.J.N. Karunakaran, present principal, Mr. Dinakar Wilson, the vice principal, and Dr. A. Nehemiah, the manager of the boys' section, Dr. Mrs. Vasanta Edward, principal, and Mrs. Indira Williams, the manager of the girls' section, for making this day a grand success. May God bless all of you.
Happy Jubilee. Congratulations.
I am very proud to be a part of this occasion, and also the parents, they have cooperated very well with all our activities, and we need your cooperation in future also. Thank you.
Parshit man se gaaye sabhi badhaiya ho badhaiya.
Parshit man se gaaye sabhi badhaiya ho badhaiya.
It's a proud and exciting moment for me to be principal of Baldwin Girls High School at this very, very historic time. Looking back over the years, it's amazing to see the way God has led both the Baldwin schools through many, many difficult circumstances and has brought us to where we are today.
Happy Jubilee! Congratulations!
Having witnessed these celebrations, I feel so excited and thrilled to come back to my alma mater and to serve my alma mater as the manager of the school.
I've been here more than 25 years, but I've never seen such a wonderful show. It was excellent. And I'm really proud to be part of the celebrations because I'm one of those lucky ones who was present during centenary, and I'm present here on the 25th year as the vice principal.
Wisdom,
Baldwin Academy,
our true guiding light,
Baldwin Academy,
onward Baldwin's onward,
hold the banner high,
happy jubilee, congratulations, on a happy jubilee,
congratulations.